We're all equal in God's sight. So that's why it's really good to have everybody here. And so I'm especially excited this evening. We've got a long tradition of working for justice for all people, but especially for those who are incarcerated. And Russell Maroon Shoats, who's been both incarcerated for a long time, but also, I believe I heard, the person who's been locked away in solitary confinement longer than any other person. And that, my sisters and brothers, is a human rights violation. That's a grave injustice. So y'all being here tonight is a way of protesting against that. I was with Professor Cornell West earlier this week, and Professor West says, if you love your brother and sister, that means you work for justice. If you love your sister and brother, you work for justice. So y'all being here today is part of that long tradition of justice. And I'm really excited about the music we're going to have, the speakers we're going to have. So it's great to have y'all here.
Welcome. My name is Fred Ho, and inaugurating the international campaign to free Russell Maroon Shoats. Why I say international is it because simultaneous to this event in London, England, a campaign has started there, and we're hoping that Selma James will call in and you'll hear from her in London. It's a 6-hour time difference, so their event already happened. So this is very, very exciting. My role today is to tell you a little bit about Scientific Soul Sessions and why Russell Maroon Shoats, in particular, is important to us, and also to play a solo baritone saxophone piece to bring in the spirit for this evening. Right. Scientific Soul Sessions is in its infancy. It's not even 2.5 years old. In my estimation and opinion, it is the freshest, most creative, most innovative, and most soulful revolutionary force to emerge on this planet in the last 112 years. And I will tell you why for the following reasons. One, we are revolutionaries. We don't believe capitalism is fixable. Therefore, two, we aren't complicit in the nonprofit industrial system. We don't seek grants. We are completely self-sufficient, self-reliant, and we believe in the importance of prefiguration. What does that mean? Prefiguration means that if you want to see systemic, fundamental, social, cultural, structural change, you have to manifest that change now. It is not something that comes afterwards, because that process in which you try to achieve it, if you don't embody and personify it now, you'll never accomplish it. So it means being that change you want to see happening now in everything we do. So that's what prefiguration means. Third, we're multi-generational. Our members are from age 7 to 76. With a heavy-duty emphasis on the younger generation, in training them in very difficult, arduous boot camp style to become the future revolutionary leaders. No more of this stuff we tell our old war stories about the 60s and 70s and expect you to go gaga over us. No. Our job is to train you hard. At the same time, our veterans, our elders, must become better. Fourth, we are majority oppressed nationalities. Meaning, if you're Asian, African, so-called Latino, indigenous, you are the majority in our organization. That's important. Fifthly, we are eco-socialists. Meaning that we don't subscribe to the opinion that the natural world is something for humans to dominate, control, or profit from. In fact, just the opposite. Humans must subordinate and submit themselves to Mother Earth.
That's right.
Seventh, we are matriarchalists. We are the opposite of patriarchy. We don't believe that gender should continue. The abolition of gender is crucial to the liberation of humanity. Rightful return to the producers, the fruits of their labor. One women bear 100% of the world's children. If they do 60% of the world's work, grow 70% of the world's food, earn only 10% of the world's income, and own less than 1% of the world's property, which is patriarchy, the opposite is matriarchy. And lastly, very controversial point, we believe in the re-socialization of men to become mothers. That will be the end, the ultimate end of patriarchy. And lastly, we are indigenous-centric. That the best society that this planet had ever seen, one without classes, without a prison industrial complex, without capital punishment, with very fluid conception of gender, with the complete enfranchisement of children, with the native peoples of this continent. No society has been better, more democratic, and that is the model we aspire to in terms of human social relations. That is what Scientific Soul Sessions is about. If you're interested, we have a sign-up sheet back there. You can pick up our literature. Why are we interested in Russell Maroon Shoats? Not just because Russell Maroon Shoats has been a black liberation fighter and a revolutionary for all of his life, majority of his adult life. Not just because of that. There are other political prisoners that we also support that are also of that sort of commitment. Russell Maroon Shoats shares our interest in innovating revolutionary theory in practice. What do I mean by that? Russell Maroon Shoats struggles with the machismo and the patriarchy and the male chauvinism of his fellow comrades, folks from the 60s and 70s. He does not accept, he rejects authoritarian vanguardism. He rejects the cult of personality. That type of criticism and self-criticism we find to be very refreshing and invigorating and something we need for this movement. But more than that, Russell Maroon Shoats is a member of Scientific Soul Sessions. Russell Maroon Shoats' daughter, Teresa Shoats, is a member of Scientific Soul Sessions. So Russell Maroon Shoats is our family. That is why we are so focused upon Russell Maroon's case, because he's an innovator, he continues to develop politically and personally, and that he is a member of Scientific Soul Sessions. So to start off this evening, to pay homage to Russell Maroon Shoats, the black liberation struggle, including some of our distinguished comrades here, Herman Ferguson, Yalua Ferguson, Muhammad Ahmed, and many, many others, I'm going to play a piece entitled Free New Africa Boogaloo. The civil rights movement asserted that the proper response to unjust laws is to break them. The Black Power, Black Liberation Movement asserted that black freedom could not happen without the end of the U.S. empire and the liberation of land. And as an eco-socialist, I would say that that liberation of land must require human submission and subordination to Mother Earth. Thank you.